Hello everybody, I'm Luis and let's talk about the Revit API and is moving to NetCore 7 or maybe 8. But let's talk about that in this video. And basically Autodesk is gonna move all the desktop application to NetCore. So NetCore 7 in the preview and probably gonna be 8, I guess. Pretty sure. And Autodesk is creating a webinar to show what to show all the stuff you need to worry about in all the AutoCAD, the Revit, Inventor, and so on. So I'm gonna put this in the description so you can enter in that and see what you need to worry about. But in this video, I'm gonna update this project, this design auto, this dependent injection project that I create only for Revit 24. I don't know why, but I'm gonna create for Revit 2019 and so on. And I'm gonna add for Revit 25. Yeah. And you can test in the preview, but you need to enter the Revit Autodesk preview agreement and so on. So let's go in my project and take a look. In this project, my template already is ready for that. So if I go double click in my project in here, I have all the configuration, the CS project configuration, and I have this Revit selection. So depending of my configuration, you're gonna select a new Net framework and gonna set a Revit version to change this in here. This Revit, all main versions for all the dependencies for Revit. And if I go in dependencies and go in here, Revit all main versions, I have all four DOLs, assemblies that I need to build this project. So I don't need to have Revit installed in my machine. Can build in using GitHub Action. That's this project is doing as well. So let's build for, let's change and add the configuration for version 19 first, and then I'm gonna wait for Revit 25. So let's go. And first I can go in here, configuration manager. I'm gonna create the version for the debug version. So let's go in here and let's create new. Let's create a debug 2019, yes. And I'm gonna create a new configuration. So we're gonna appear in that. And let's use this one for the to copy settings. It doesn't have any settings, but anyway. So I'm gonna create that, gonna appear in here, and I'm gonna do the same for the version, for the release version that in this project doesn't have anything in front. So yeah, just that. And yeah, basically like this. And if you build with version 19, basically gonna set for this framework, Net 4.7, and gonna use the Revit 20 for the assemblies. So that's basically it for this build. And if I go and build this project, let's build this project, this automation, gonna build for version 19 and version 24, yes. And basically gonna add the missing versions to the version 19 and so on. So basically I can work with this project in all versions 19, 20, 21 and so on. But in this case, gonna use the version 19 for the version 20, 21, so it's until version 25. Yeah. And yeah, so you go in here. Yeah. Actually, version 25 gonna break if I try that. But if I go in here in the components, gonna create the version 19 and 24. And the middle versions gonna add this one, 2021, 22, 23. Using version 19 and version next version, I'm gonna try to use that, but if I try to build, gonna break because it's using NetCore, and that we're gonna change it right now. So I'm gonna do the same here. Let's create a version, the debug version. What is it? What is it? Wait, new. Yep. Debug. 25. Yes. Let's use this one. Great. And let's go new. 25. And this one. Yes. Okay. We build that. Probably gonna fail. That's a little strange. Yeah, kind of is working. Because it doesn't have a configuration for version 25. Yeah, it's using this one. That's version 17. So let's create a new one here. Yes. So probably my new template gonna be ready when Rev 25 gonna be released, maybe in April. So, and here gonna be net 7.0 Windows, I guess. That's one thing. And probably gonna fail in the package. Yeah. All my packages is already ready for that. But the Revit all main versions gonna fail, so I need to change in here to enable a preview version. So let's build that. Let's save and build again. Yes, now get the last version, that's a preview version. So gonna get the four assemblies for the preview version, and now it's building fine. I guess let's take a look in here. Let's open my project. Let's change to version 25. Yes, let's build again, just to make sure. Let's open here, open this one. Yes, let's go in here, let's go in the bin, let's go in the release here, the version 25. Yeah, That's one thing that's missing, some configuration. By the way, because I'm using Net Core now, I have this JSON file that's basically gonna have some information for the package and other stuff. Yeah, and you can use. I'm not sure if this is gonna work in Revit, but I usually add this configuration that's gonna basically gonna work as before, basically gonna put out the assembly in this folder and gonna ignore that basically. So I'm gonna go in here and gonna add this in here. Could it work? Basically I'm adding this configuration. If my properties, my target frame start with net 4, not start, so that's an Net Core basically. I'm gonna add this, enable dynamic loading to true, generic runtime configuration to true as well, and generic dependence file to false. Yeah, basically this. If I build again, I'm pretty sure, yeah, gonna add this configuration. All my dependence gonna be in here, like the version 24, basically the same. And I'm still gonna have this JSON file configuration runtime that basically gonna say I'm using version 7 for the net core. Yeah. And the rest doesn't matter too much. Yeah. And if I put this in Revit, gonna work fine. And yeah, that's basically it, I guess. And if I build this automation again, should work fine, I guess. And gonna build and gonna put the version 25 in the new folder. Yes. And another thing I could do as well that probably gonna work. I could change this net target framework to true. So let's change that. True. Yes. That's the automation gonna do the same, but let's wait a little bit. And yes, basically if I go back in here, let's take a look here. Yes, gonna be version 19, version 24, version 25, and gonna add the missing versions just to make sure, and gonna add the version still doesn't exist, but gonna be prepared to add the reference for the new version in this one. Yeah, and gonna build the package builder. And if I go back in here, go my package builder, go my bundle. Yeah, if I open this one, yeah, basically gonna add version 19, 24, 25, and gonna have all the missing versions as well. And inside my content, I have the version, I need to change the version 24. Yes, still the same. 19, great, and 25 as well. This is a little wrong, but I'm gonna build again to fix that. Probably kind of change this when I was building. Yes. Let's build again just to make sure. Before that, let's change in here. Yes, let's update this version. This is gonna be version 1.0.1. Yes. This is 0107. Yes, that's great. Release version 25, I guess. Using net 4.7.0. Good enough. And let's change this to dash 1.0.1. Yes, it's gonna be this as well. Great. And I need to change the version in here to 1. Great. If I build that, yes, now I'm building like this. It's not a big deal. My automation gonna remove that. Let's build again and make sure. And by the way, the automation is in here, this build project, and I'm using this application to create an application for, let's go here, for this guy. Yeah, gonna build for that. And in all the versions, gonna run this one. And because my net core dependency doesn't have any strange stuff, probably gonna work fine in the preview version, in the release version as well for the Revit 25. So yeah. Yes, it builds with a new version. If I go back in my bin project here, this should be a version, next version. This is fine, and this is fine as well. So great. That's basically, I should remove this package. Yeah, not gonna be a problem. But anyway, that's basically it, I guess. Let's go back in here. I need to change this to version 19, I guess. Just to make sure. Yes, let's build this. Only save, I guess. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that is done. Yes, but don't forget to give a like in this video. And if you want more information about the Netcore migration, you can go in this webinar, link in the description. And that's it. Let's build this and release in the GitHub. And yes, so thanks for watching and see you. Bye bye.